Tasul, Conrad, and Nora created a real legacy for us around conservation science with polar bears that really helps scientists better understand the species. It's critical that we have as much information as we possibly can, as quickly as we can, so we can understand how polar bears are adapting and changing in a rapidly warming Arctic. Polar bears in zoos provide two unique opportunities for scientists. One is they're accessible, and the other is that we see them day after day. And those are both things that are not available to people studying bears in the wild. They're incredibly hard to get to. There's only certain times a year you can even access them. They certainly don't want to work with you. And to find that same bear again in the future, it's just not often possible. With Tasul, we did a study where the biologist placed an accelerometer device on the collar, and I think of that as what you have in your cell phone that tells it which direction it's facing. We were able to create a library of what those signals look like when she's walking or swimming or running or standing up or lying down, that now you can use that library to take the data coming back from a wild bear and really say with more precision than we ever have before what that animal is doing moment to moment, even though it's several thousand miles away. Polar bears really crave novelty. They actually enjoy the projects that we're involved in. One of the important questions we've always had about polar bears is, what are the energetic costs of walking or running? I remember distinctly when we were working with Tasul for walking on a treadmill. When the treadmill first started moving, I expected her to back out, to leave, and to say, this is too weird. And honestly, she just sort of looked down at her feet and looked up again and took another fish, and we slowly ramped the speed up, and she's like, okay, I get this. This is interesting. Polar bears are entirely dependent on the sea ice. That's where they hunt, it's where they breed, it's where they rest, and it's often where they give birth. We know that the sea ice is retreating. It's becoming thinner, it's taking longer to form each year, and it's melting sooner in the spring. So what does it cost a polar bear to swim? We don't know the answer to that question, but it's an important one as we see the sea ice retreat. By building essentially a metabolic chamber that an animal can swim in, where we can collect its respirations and do some analyses, we can start to put numbers, actual calorie costs of what it takes a bear to swim over distance. It's never been done before, and it'll help us better understand what it means to be a polar bear in the warming Arctic. Polar Passage is our new polar bear habitat that is under construction now. There will be a deep pool and a shallow pool and elevated areas for bears to see out over people. When our guests come and experience Polar Passage, I want them to think about polar bears and their place on the planet. We all share it. We're all impacted by our actions. Something must change, and we have to take action if we want this planet and our own lives to be as beautiful and diverse as they are now into the future. Conrad, Tasul, and Nora inspired us to build a habitat worthy of them. And we're gonna have great opportunities to continue to advance all the things that we care about.